Welcome to the Salvation Links. Today's topic is deceptive spirit. Our Lord is warning us against that spirit, a deceptive spirit that is flying around in the world right now. As you know, as God needs human beings to carry out his good will on earth, so the devil also needs human beings to carry out his deceptive will on earth. Have you been involved in a deceptive marriage that almost killed you? Or are you involved in a deceptive marriage right now and you're finding a way out? Have you been involved in a deceptive business investment that almost wiped out your bank account? Are you still in it? Or have you been introduced to a deceptive philosophy that is making you to do things in the wrong way today? By the grace of God, we're going to pray against it, and the Lord is answering our prayers today in Jesus' name. But for us, before we get into that, let us see what the Word of God is saying in the book of Romans 3:13 in Jesus' name. It said, their throats are open graves, their tongues practice deceit, the poison of vipers is on their lips. In Jesus' name, the Lord is making us to understand that people's throats are open grave. People don't tell the truth anymore. Everybody is looking for a way to deceive others, even among families. For goodness sake, even in the marriage, people pretend about anything. What about the government that are ruling us this day? We don't even know when our politicians are, when their yes is yes anymore. Everybody lies. They just, it's a deceptive messages they throw out there just to keep us on our edge in the name of Lord Jesus. But today, the Lord is warning us. The same situation is actually happening in the church. Deceptive messages. But let me take you to a story that is in the Bible. It's a story about a prophet, an old deceptive prophet, an old prophet that lies. So there is a young man, a young prophet that went from Judah to Bethel to instruct the king Jeroboam of his wrongdoing. And the Lord warned him that the way you go is not the same way you're going to come back when you're coming back. And when you get to that place, do not eat or drink or sleep over there. This young man did exactly what the Lord told him to do. But on his way home, an old prophet ran after him. And let me just take it to the Bible verse. 1 Kings 13 verse 18. It says, the old prophet answered, I too am a prophet, as you know. An angel said to me by the word of the Lord, bring him back with you to drink to your house so that he may eat bread and drink water. But he was lying to him. Unfortunately, the young prophet followed this old prophet. He ate and drank in his house, but on his way home, he was killed on the way home by the lions. So the word of God is coming to us today that be very careful on what you listen to. Today, our prayer is that Lord will give us the spirit of discernment in everything we're doing, that we will know when people are deceiving us, even right from our family. And also, the Lord will give us the spirit of God that we will not deceive others. In Jesus' name, amen. Father, I thank you. I glorify your powerful name for the for your children today. Father, I pray against every deceptive spirit. Father God Almighty, because the spirit enters people and uses people, even those that we trust, to deceive us. Father, I pray by the power of the Holy Spirit today, we rebuke every deceptive spirit. We come against them by the power and the blood of Lord Jesus. They will not see us. They will not see any of our family. And anywhere we go, the Spirit of God will hover over us. When the deceptive spirit sees us, they will run away. Because what? Because why? Day and night don't come together in the name of Lord Jesus. And we are the children of light. In Jesus' name, amen. That is the word of God for you today. Be very careful, be very vigilant at work, at your business, in your family, even in the house of the Lord. Until next time, God bless you.